subscribe on YouTube, follow us on Twitter, OPFC1937. I'm here with
Zanele Ngobo.
Zanele Ngobo, what do you think is going to happen today?
I believe that my team will rectify the mistake that they did in 2013 in the Champions League and will be crowned champions. But today's game, the first leg, was the first step, because we need to score goals and not concede. This is the most important part, not concede goals. And then we're going to take it the second leg when we play next week, Sunday, where we'll be finishing the job off.
What do you think about Pirates and Sahel's record? Sahel is very good at home but bad at home. Away, Pirates is very good away but bad at home. What do you think will happen?
I would like to start talking about Pirates. I believe that Pirates' reason for them being poor at home and then good away is I believe that they tend to perform quite well when they are away from home without their fans looking over them, when they know that the rest of the country is watching them and amongst other people don't believe in them. So they raise above the occasion and they do quite well. As for the team that we play against us all, I believe that it's regardless of the form of what their record home and away, at match day it doesn't count, because who takes his chances on the match day will be the winners, and I believe it's going to be my team though.
And do you know that this team is the second biggest team in terms of African dominance? Are you scared of that?
No, we've beat Al Ahly, come on, we've beat Zamalek. So we've played against TP Mazembe and we sent them a new, the late sent them a new, did wonders for us, the whole team. So I don't believe it's about history, it's about what you're going to put on that match day. So my team's going to conquer.
Brighton Mkhwanga is back. Do you think he should start or Vono should keep his place?
Honestly, Brighton should sit on the bench, as it's gonna be unfair on Ovono and other goalkeepers to just come back from injuries and start to play. Also, think about Brighton. If he makes a mistake and end up losing, people are gonna say we lost the game because Brighton play and whatnot. Above all of that, I believe Brighton needs to fully get his fitness level on track, because he still have a long season to go. He's still gonna play the league, gonna play the Network Cup, and he's still gonna go back to Africa next season in the Champions League. So we need our players armed and ready and full recovered and all injuries.
Sfisamien is back. Should he get a few minutes or he should sit on the bench?
He should sit on the bench because there are a lot of players that are capable of playing as well. Same applies to the reason of him playing. We're going to put him under pressure. We're throwing in the deep end in the end of the day. So he just has to gradually get his form. Maybe a few minutes if you considered our score when we've played well, then you can introduce him on the second leg, because you need to spring some few surprises in the second leg as well.
And then Kabuza played two matches in Angola and in South Africa. Do you think the strain of traveling and the minutes he played, should he start the whole match or should Majoro come in and then he finishes off the game, or go with the tried and tested?
I haven't seen the starting 11. So the only changes that we have is Sonolo Masalisa coming in for Isasa. So as for Kabuza,
is that a good change?
I would, you know, one thing is we the fans, we don't know what happens in training grounds. So Eric Tinkler, and let's say his nickname, Eric Tinkler is the one who knows why he opted for Masalisa. But you need to remember that I think Isasa came back late from national team, regardless that he didn't play for Senegal, but he came back late. So maybe the coach saw that Masalisa put up a good effort at training, so that's why he opted to play. As for Kabuza and the players that have been in Mafana duties, I was worried, especially Matlaba, considering the player he runs the entire 90 minutes. So to play two games without being substituted was a worrying factor for me. But on the Tuesday game, I thought that Shakes did a justice for us a bit in taking out Kabuza a few minutes and then he played other players. So I think Kabuza will do well, but you just have to, I don't know, you just have to control his tempo of the game. That's the only thing I like to say.
Prediction and scorers.
Prediction, I would like to see my favorite player score.
Who's that?
Thabo Rakgale. But yeah, overall, I'm just looking for the team to do well. Like, it could be, if it's not a 2-0 or 1-0 score, it could be a 0-0 draw. A 0-0 draw is better for us, because if you score for them away from home, they need to double the goal we scored. So if it's not a 0-0, it's fine. If it's 2-0 for us, I'm happy, I'm ecstatic. 2-0, 1-0 is fine. But you should not concede. That's the most important part, not concede today at home.
Thank you. That was the view of a fan. She says 2-0 is a good score, even a 0-0 draw, because she's confident that away we will wrap up the points. Cats here for Orlando Pirates Fan TV signing out. Thanks.